Hey YouTube, and welcome to Tell Samira. Today I'm going to talk about miracles because I do believe they happen. And by the way, I am Samira. So my miracle happened when I was about 10 years old. I was going to the local swimming pool, and I was very excited because I wasn't allowed to go a lot of places by myself. So I don't even know this day how I was even allowed to go. But anyway, so I had went through my mother's closet. She used to keep a lot of clothes from the 70s and from the 60s. And she had this two-piece bathing suit, and it was in blue jean, okay? So I thought I was cute. I dug that thing right out of that closet and put it on, and it fit. I was so happy. You couldn't tell me nothing because I was a cute girl. So anyway, I put this suit on and I go across the street. You know, I'm ready, and I can't swim, okay? I'm scared of the water still to this day, but I get over there all cute and I'm ready to go. I get into about the 3 feet because that's my safety zone. If you don't know how to swim and you're scared of water, you probably hang out in the 3 feet and the 5 feet. Don't let anybody shame you. You know what you're doing. So I knew what I was doing that day. So I get into 3 feet and I'm like, splashing a little water. I didn't go with any friends, so it was a lot of people there, you know, just playing around with their friends, hanging out on the side of the pool. I noticed a lifeguard, it's only one. He's flirting, you know, with girls that's walking past. So after that, I got a little more confident in the 3 feet. So I'm like, okay, you know, I'm doing my thing. I do that in the water. I don't know what was going on. I guess if you can't swim, you need to feel good about yourself and do something. So I get bolder. I go over into the 5 feet, right? So I'm over there and I'm just splashing around, having a good time just by myself, just loving the day. It's hot. It's beautiful out. Seeing a lot of kids out there. So I'm like, okay. And, you know, by this time, I end up somehow getting over into the 12 feet. And I didn't do that on purpose. Believe me, that was not on purpose. I think it was all that I was doing in the 5 feet that I accidentally slipped and floated myself over the 12 feet. And all I knew something was wrong when I could no longer feel my foot at the bottom. See, that was my safety. I always need to feel my foot at the bottom of the little swimming pool. That didn't happen. So I felt myself going down, and only thing I saw was someone's arm, and I attached to him to his arm. After that, I blanked out. You know, because I really thought I was going to die. When I woke up, I was on the side of the pool, you know, and I don't know how long I was out. But when I tell you, when I set up, the first thing that some boy said to me is, oh, my friend says you got a big butt. And I'm thinking, a big butt? What? I almost drowned in the pool. When I say I looked up, the lifeguard was still sitting up there flirting with the girls. Everybody was going on about their business like nothing happened. And this was not a huge swimming pool at that, you know? So I'm thinking nobody was around me, no paramedics, no one trying to resuscitate me, get me back to life. It was like nothing had happened. So I never knew who pulled me out the pool, what happened. And I was so shaken up at whatever you said, that nobody had acknowledged what had happened to me, that I said, let me just leave here. I left with my life. And after that, I left and I went home. And the thing is, I don't think I ever told my mother, because like I said, I couldn't go places by myself, and it just so happened that I went that day. So I didn't want to tell her, because if I want to try to go somewhere else again by myself, I didn't want to think, and I can't send this child to the swimming pool. She almost died. Now, another time I almost died in the swimming pool. This piece here is not a miracle though, but I thought I almost died, but I really didn't. I'm just further saying how crazy I am when it comes to pools. So I was there with a group of friends. This was a different swimming pool, maybe a year later. And somehow again, I guess I didn't learn my lesson from the first time. I'm in the 5 feet. Woo! Somehow I'm in the 6 feet. And then I'm screaming to them, help, help, talks to my group of friends, and I see them, they're still sitting on the outside, you know? And then I noticed that people were trying to help me because they were trying to like get me out of the water, but I started fighting them because I was trying to push their head down to save myself. So embarrassing. But I kept pushing their head down because I couldn't breathe. And I figured if I pushed their head down, I could try to breathe. I was probably 11. Don't judge me. Anywho. So finally, somebody outside of the pool screamed to me and said, "Stand on your tippy toes and just walk out the pool." And I did it. And then I was able to actually get my head above the water and walk out the pool. That wasn't a good situation. Needless to say, my friends were so mad at me because they told me they had sent people in the water to help me and I was beating them up under the water. And so me and those friends, we never talked again after that. That relationship was over. I guess they said, "This girl here is crazy, gonna die and kill other people. We can't be around her." And all I have to say is I can't blame them. If you like this video, go ahead and subscribe and like it and tell me your own story. What miracles have happened in your life? So for me, I thank God for that. The first one, not the second. You know, the first one, because I know, like I said, that was God's hand in keeping me alive. All right, have a good one.